think Victor makes a lot of sense. Victor securing their wave clear. This is a team comp that has fairly brought out the one game in the top lane. So Darshan, it's going to be up to him to try to survive this laning phase. And oh, hook comes out.
A quick hook onto Bang. He's able to get a bit of safety. Concussive blows, knocks in Winter's Biden. Bye-bye, Wiggly.
So well done from 100 Thieves there. They had snuck around the side and just completely baked.
They
should be looking to attack. Now that they've gotten the flash out, I want to see them repeat the play, but here's two-man top. Darshan, no flash.
Flashed in on him, and that's going to be bad. He didn't pick up any resistances, just a little bit of HP, and they're able to cut right through that. Darshan goes down for first blood to Someday.
And that is so disastrous because it's
in top, or if Wiggly decides to go up and help, not a lane you're really going to gank for as Someday can just walk away.
Round two, Riv.
He is trying. He can get in here with flash this time. Alpha Moo would be a great one to hit, but stand aside can go to Bang if Bang gets the safety. They have a really great way to get out of this. If he W's in, there it is, a little bit of range. No, the hook is there from Biofrost, and they walk it in and get the kill as well. Alpha Moo goes down.
Fantastic repeat gank there from CLG. Good target selection as well. You know that Aphromoon has no flash. He is the kill target there. They will be able to knock him down, but this is Spellbook Grom, so he's going to TP straight back. So it will just be the kill, but that is a fairly brazen TP, and they might just look to try back again.
Watch the minions. Concussive blows. Gets the hook in before the last hit. He's going to have Ignite on him. A few more shots. Unbreakable's down. There it is. Stixxay finds the shot.
That TP sucked. What are you doing, oh my god!
It was on the bottom side of the map, so you don't really get to have fun now that you've fallen behind.
You have to play it really, really safe. And it is CLG playing to their bot side advantage, grabbing the Inferno.
Tell CLG that they cannot get in. And that will be over to 100 Thieves for a Mountain 2 and Infernal on the side.
And he's done a great job of continuing that pressure, but it's on him to do that, right? Darshan is fairly even in farm. We'll see if he can pull off this dive, though. Does have his ultimate.
Pulls a TP in. Beautiful pressure. It's like Darshan throws on the Zhonya's. It's going to be World Ender there, and Bang's going to pick himself up a kill. He's been waiting all lane so patiently, and he can pull the trigger there on Darshan. Top side for CLG to take down the turret. It looks like Stixxay keeping mid turrets up on both sides. It looks like Top's going to get a little bit of love if somebody engages.
Oh, no! Wiggly chooses first.
He gets antsy in the pantsy. They're going on to Hoohee, but look, it's on to surprise! And now they're going to bring Biofrost into the fight. He throws the shield down to give a little bit of mitigation, and it's just enough. Storm is raining on Hoohee's parade here. If he can get another strike down with that laser, don't think it's going to be in range. Flashes for flash there. Good job by
solo Q style carry. Bill,
you got to get a little beef in there. Oh, don't reset. There we go.
Just think about it.
Yeah. Game with power of evil. He is putting down some power.
And because he's so strong, there's actually a TP coming in behind.
Oh, Realm Warp on the gravity field. Not too much damage coming through, but it's a 2v1, so Power of Evil's trying to get himself a little bit of room to work with here. On to Over the Wall. It's going to be freeze the crowd before he goes down. And that's going to be a hit for Someday and Hoohee. So Someday feeling real good to get
it actually started up. CLG knows they are in the area. It'll still do a lot of damage to him, but they're going for the fight.
First sweet Q, second sweet Q. Over the Wall goes on to once again. His follow has been spectacular this game. And always in the right choice. Now they're on to Baron.
And this is the double Mountain Dragon turret. So the Baron is just gone. Look at it melt.
Beautifully done.
They're going to want to catch the result of the weekly wager. Kobe
or
Mark are going to be sounded squeaky on the desk after this one.
Catch the result of this one. Hoohee stopwatch. Storm is on. And that may just rain on Hoohee's parade. He goes down. CLG get a little breathing room here as they're getting pushed up to the base.
We'll see if 100 Thieves can get anything with that. It means a Baron on respawn, you can pretty much kill instantly with the amount of damage they have on their squad. And Triple Mountain, a huge force in the teamfights when they are fighting behind an Ornn.
It feels good to be max item before the game end, but when that realization hits, it's to be in.
Yeah, it really is. As you say, you know, that's where you can get picked off. And they're on to Hoohee here. We'll see if 100 Thieves can answer.
Chaos Storm topside. Teleport coming in as well. They're sending four here with a teleport for Hoohee. That can't be stopped. That's an uh-oh. That's Someday throwing on World Ender right away. Here comes Darshan's horn, and he's going to be able to knock it in a nice spot.
Oh,
no
so
grab
close.
Onto Someday. But
straight into the Baron pit, but that is spotted immediately.
A lot of vision.
Rush it down.
Aphromoo gets hit up. Gravity Field is there. He'll be able to break tank on that. And it looks like he gets himself to somewhat safety as somewhat's going down as well. A nice burn on the Baron with the Mountain Drakes. Andok could be looking to go in. He's got the Guardian Angel, and they may not want this fight. Aphromoo Glacial Fissure back for someday with World Ender on as it falls off. Guardian Angels are keeping them healthy, but looks like CLG wants to route the fight. They are bringing it to 100 Thieves. Andok's low, tries to hookshot in, gets himself the Guardian Angel, but also keeps Wiggly in a spot. Beautiful job while he's down to try and help the team coming up now, and it might not be enough. We'll have to see. He's back onto Stixate. The backline wanted to be free as they lose Wiggly. They lose Aphromoo on either side. A one for one is now. Stixate is down, and it is going to possibly be CLG's fight with the power of evil. But Bang is alive, and Bang is slinging. The gun is loaded, and he is on Power of Evil's heels. There's the connection. There's the hits, and Bang has scored the ace for 100 Thieves.
And that is the team fighting of a two-time world champ.
Just try to go for the end.
I absolutely love that by Onda. Staying in the back line, the rest of 100 Thieves pulling CLG through the fight, so Stixate is in the middle. Can't do anything about it, and 100 Thieves knew they had the upper hand once it started going. And his Bang was getting a lot more kills, or I should say players on his team, not teams.
Yeah, look how fast it dives. Again, Triple Mountain is just allowing them to do these plays that you otherwise would not be able to do. I mean, they were detected on the Baron. His damnedest to keep him away. Here this may be the wave. We'll see. He doesn't want to risk it.
True shot browser across. W wears off. It's only going to be an auto anyways. He goes in, and that's going to be as well. Stixate trying to get the light shot through, but he does not tag enough damage. Biofrost and Stixate now box themselves in, but is it going to be enough to keep the enemy at bay? Here comes Onda flipping into the fight. There goes Wiggly as Stixate and Biofrost again towards the back of the fight, trying to keep themselves alive, but there's just too much power from 100 Thieves in the base.
Yeah, they're going to close this one out.
Either side, and they get double respawn in, which takes a little bit of attention from 100 Thieves, but they're still in it to win it.
Yeah, they are closing it out pretty slowly, but they have the ocean. Bang is healed back up to full, and I think this should be the final push.
Onda looking for the sidekicks here, but they're going to go for the full fight. CLG get torn apart in their own houses. Now it's the Nexus. They focus for 100 Thieves, and 100 Thieves come away with a victory.
Really nicely done there from 100 Thieves, utilizing a dominant top lane. Such a strong weekend from Someday, getting the solo advantages, working fantastically well with Onda to snowball that, and that is really where they got their pressure from. That is how they got to the late game, securing those dragons, securing those barons, and slowly